Hello, friends, and happy sunny Thursday. It is so good to be with you today. It is bright and sunny here in Indiana, and it's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and just getting ready to have my second cup of coffee. I need some energy this afternoon, but I wanted to come at you with a word today, just something that I felt like was on my heart today. I was talking to a really good friend of mine, and as I have shared in messages with you before, I have a standing conversation every week with my best friend, and we just talk every Wednesday at 11 o'clock, and yesterday was my birthday, so we didn't talk yesterday. We actually rescheduled for today, and we ended up having almost a 2.5 hour conversation, and it was so good. I love those conversations where God shows up. I mean, we are not usually even 5 minutes into the conversation when we have our Bibles open and we are ready to have a conversation as to what God is speaking to us about. And that happened again today. So I am so grateful for that. But one of the things that I wanted to share with you today, and it was a conversation that we had today. It's a conversation I feel like we have been talking about, her and I, for a very long time. And it is this conversation, this ongoing conversation about what it means to be in the Word of God and how important it is to get into the Word. And what we've been talking about over the course of the last several months is the difficulty that we can have when we first start getting into the Word. I have been a Christian my entire life, but I didn't get serious, really serious, about studying Scripture until about 2010. I had left my staff position at a church, and that's for a whole nother video, but I was on staff at a church for 7.5 years, and I had just left that staff position, and I was really in this place, in this season of time, where I needed to hear from the Lord, and I was seeking after Him like crazy, and I really got serious about getting into the Word of God. And so I have really been in and studying Scripture now for a good 10, 11 years, but I remember those early days and how difficult it was. And there were some times where I would just come to the Word of God wanting to learn, wanting to understand what I read, but really not doing a very good job with it. I would come faithfully every day. I would open up the Scriptures. I would read something, and it would never fail that I would walk away having no greater knowledge than I had when I first opened my Bible. And it was frustrating. And I know how frustrating it can be when we want to learn and we want to know and we want to grow and nothing seems to be making sense. And I want to give you some encouragement today because I know where that, I know what it feels like to be in that place. And if you find yourself in that place, for one thing, you need to know you're not alone. Many of us go through that. In fact, I feel like many of us go through the hills and the valleys of studying Scripture. We go through these seasons where we might really be on fire and we really might like be all about studying and getting into our Word and understanding and praying and doing all these things we know we're supposed to do. But really, there are realities that come with that. And sometimes we end up in the valley. And sometimes we get into a dry place where we're like, nothing feels new, and His voice doesn't sound, you know, it does. His voice isn't really, we feel like He's not talking to us. Like we get into this place where we feel dry and we feel like we're not growing. And I want you to know, first and foremost, you're not alone. I want you to know that even this stems all the way back to the actual Word of God in the time when Jesus was teaching His disciples. And one of the things we know from reading the Gospels is that Jesus loved to communicate in parables. You know, we read about the 10 talents, we read about the wheat and the tares, we read about all of these wonderful parables in Scripture, and they're beautiful and they're wonderful. But what happens a lot of time is when we begin to read those, we get frustrated because we don't understand them, right? We're like, I don't really know how this has anything to do with modern day time or what I'm dealing with in my life right now. But there is hope in that, and there's beauty in that, and there's mercy in that, and I'm about to show you that. In Matthew chapter 13, Jesus is talking to His disciples, and He had just finished talking with them in verse 13, he's talking about, he just finished all of these parables. So we have, some of the parables that he's talking about? Well, the one right before this is he's talking about the parable of the farmer scattering seed. And so he had just finished wrapping this particular parable up when in verse 10, his disciples ask him this question. It says his disciples came and asked him, "Why do you use parables when you talk to people?" And you could imagine, like, for me, I'm a visual learner, so I could imagine these guys being really frustrated and being like, "Jesus, don't you know if you just shared your heart with them, like if you just came out and like told them what they needed to know instead of talking in these riddles and these stories and these parables that really don't make any sense to people, they might be better off to understand what it is that you're trying to communicate to them." But Jesus, in his wisdom and in his kindness and in his love and his mercy, says this. In verse 11, he replied, "You are permitted to understand the secrets of the kingdom of heaven, but others are not." So remember, he's talking to his men. He's talking to his closest friends. He's talking to his students, his disciples. And he's saying, "You are permitted to know the secrets of heaven, but they are not." Verse 12, he goes on to say, "To those who listen to my teaching, more understanding will be given, and they will have an abundance of knowledge. But for those who are not listening, even what little understanding they have will be taken away from them." And it's interesting. Again, I feel like even Jesus's answer was a parable. And I love the thought that Jesus doesn't speak in parables for us to be confused. He doesn't speak in parables for us to be frustrated. He speaks in parables so that those who have a real desire in their heart to seek after him, to know him personally, to study out the scriptures for the truth, will find it. He is so good that he gives us parables so that those who do not currently understand will understand, because they will have a real hunger after truth and after what it is that Jesus is really trying to say. And so I love the thought that Jesus actually hides these little nuggets of truth and revelation and knowledge and wisdom inside his parables, so that those who are ready and willing to obey will understand. You know, it's interesting, when I first started my serious journey with Jesus, when I really got serious about reading the scriptures, I remember thinking, "God, I just want it all now. I want all the knowledge now so that I can go out and proclaim your truth and I can proclaim your goodness and I can get other people on the winning side. Like, I will win souls to Jesus Christ," right? But the truth of the matter is, I wasn't in a heart position to really obey. I wasn't in the right heart posture to be able to obey what it was that I was hearing. One of the things that Jesus tells his disciples is, "There's so much more I want to tell you, but you wouldn't be able to handle it right now." And 10 years, 11 years later, from those days, those early days of studying scripture, I know that to be true now more than ever. If he would have given me the totality of what I was so craving in those early days, it would have destroyed me. It would have killed me. I would have been so puffed up in my head, full of knowledge. I would have thought that I had anything to do with it. I would have missed those moments of sitting at his feet. I would have missed, I was telling my best friend today, you know, I was in those early years so on fire for Jesus. I had so much enthusiasm in my heart of hearts to really go after my faith and really, you know, make these pledges to God to be his hands and feet in the world. But I wasn't ready in those early days, and he knew it. And if he would have given me what I really so thought that I wanted in those early days, it would have destroyed me, because I would have had a tendency, knowing me, knowing my flesh, knowing my human tendency, I would have thought that I had anything to do with the growth that was happening. I would have placed more emphasis on my ability and less focus on His sovereignty and His goodness. I just know that to be true for myself. And so He's hidden these treasures of wisdom within His word, and He hides them often in parables throughout the Gospels for us to chase after Him, for us to dive in. You know, I talked to somebody recently and she said, I get so frustrated when I read my Bible because I feel like I'm always going down these rabbit trails that lead me to other places and I can't get back to the original thing that I was studying. And I'm like, praise the Lord. Follow those rabbit trails. Follow those places in Scripture where you're like, you just need to hear God speak. You just need to hear His voice, and you are following Him through the pages of His word. And so know this, that it is in His kindness. It is the kindness of Jesus to place wisdom not so readily available for us to find it, but there it's tucked away so neatly within the pages of His word, so that those who are hungry for His word, those who are set apart from the rest of the world, those who really want to know His heart, to know His mind, to think like He thinks, to behave like He behaves, to look more like Jesus, that we will hunt the truths down. It's like a treasure hunt. We will actually search the Scriptures to hear His voice, to find His heartbeat. So know this, that it is in His kindness that He hides those things from us. It's not don't be discouraged when you come to the truth, when you come to His word and you read it and you don't understand. Just ask for wisdom. Ask for Him to impart His wisdom on you, and He will do that, and it will happen in the by and by. It will happen over time. Keep coming to His word. You know, it's interesting that I heard a pastor say once, he said, you know, oftentimes people say that they get frustrated because they read His word, they walk away, and they don't remember what they read. And it's frustrating because the older we get, we feel like we can't retain this knowledge for very long. But be encouraged with this. He said this. He said, yeah, you know what? I might not remember what I had for breakfast yesterday, but it nourished me all the same. And so be encouraged that what it is that you are reading today is planting a seed deep within you. And one day, you never know when that is going to come out and show itself, when it is going to rise to the surface, when you're going to pull that out, when you're going to be able to use that to speak maybe truth and hope and love and encouragement in someone else's life, including your own. So be encouraged today that those parables are there for a reason. They are there for the ones who are really wanting to seek after His heart with their full heart. So be encouraged today by that, friends. I love you. Thank you for being here with me, and have an awesome day with Jesus. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.